Hey guys, so last weekend we had an absolute epic day out on the water. It was one of the best days out in a long time and probably our first full day's diving in a few months. So we were pretty wrecked as you can imagine, but we pushed through, had some amazing diving, saw some amazing sharks and schools of massive hammerheads and stuff. Just check it out, it's awesome.
We weren't expecting clear water as it had been raining for weeks.
Oh yes!
Simon shot this nice 10 kilo kingfish and I took the opportunity to shoot a bigger one that came in to check his out. Happy with a good fish in the boat, I jumped in to film some of the amazing marine life around here. Unfortunately, this is all too common. We always grab what we can, and this day, Mother Nature had a great way of rewarding us. With a huge school of scalloped hammerheads. Moments like these that really keep you coming back for more. You never know what a day on the water might bring.
That was cool.
Thank you. I thought, oh, I should have a small one.
Do you reckon these are the ones we're passing up on when we're diving?
With the clear water, our perception of the kingfish was way off. Everything we shot was so much bigger than we thought. Despite my best attempt to keep the kingy away, it took a turn around our flashes. I tried to untangle it, but I just made it worse. A few minutes later, with Michael's help, we finally managed to sort it out. It was Simon's turn to put one in the boat before the end of the day. And boy, he didn't disappoint.
Hey, do you just want to go whack it in the head for us?
We've got no shame second shooting each other's fish. If it means it can be dispatched faster and eliminate all chance of losing it, then so be it. There's no room for egos here, and at the end of the day, we're here as a team and to land the fish safely, quickly, and as ethically as possible.
Oh. Oh. Yeah. I only got a PB! It might go 30 if I'm lucky.
Yeah, right.
What do you reckon?
Solid.
Oh, right there. Oh, just a little fella.
Fiddler.
Little fiddler swimming around.
Oh my god, that's 30. That's f***ing 30 for sure.
Congratulations!
Oh, thank you. That's 30 for sure.
I hope so.
Oh man, he is massive.
Yeah, I didn't. When you were holding him in the water, I was like, yeah, 20s.
I knew you didn't think it was a fair head last.
That whale didn't hurt him. He played up, don't get me wrong. Rod schools slowed down and then he come in. That's a
so
I did not think it was that big. Oh.
Unfortunately, several years back, the kingfish population was severely depleted by highly effective kingfish traps that were basically wiping out the fishery. Thankfully, that was stopped just in time, and now we are seeing huge comebacks of this fast-growing pelagic fish. Every year, I am shocked at how strong this fishery has returned. This day, we took 2 kingfish each, even though the bag limit is 5 per person. Now, if you're wondering where all this fish goes, we might not dive for another month, so this will be lucky to last us until our next trip out. We usually split our catch evenly amongst the divers, and then each of us share that with our family. We freeze what we can't eat straight away, and then we eat from our stash throughout the month. If you're interested, I've created a highlights reel on my Instagram with all the meals from one of these fish. You can follow just how many meals we get from one kingfish of around 10 kilos. Sourcing my own food is one of the most satisfying feelings in the world, and if you haven't done it yet, I'd highly encourage you to get out there and give it a go yourself.
How you got? Can you
hear it?
Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this episode, be sure to give us a thumbs up and give us a share amongst your friends. Cheers, guys.